Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Good evening, everyone. Please be seated. Welcome to this inauguration ceremony tonight for newly elected city officials for the city of Southfield for this year, 2015. We want to thank the music director of St. John's Armenian Church in Southfield, Mr. Ruben Malian, for singing the national anthem for us this evening. My name is Dave Wagner from WRCJ Radio and Detroit Public Television. I'm honored to be here tonight as the announcer for this program. I would like to now welcome to the podium Rabbi Yechiel Morris of Young Israel of Southfield, who will offer our invocation.
Please rise one more time. Heavenly Father, we've assembled here this evening to swear into office elected officials of our great city of Southfield. In this most wonderful moment, we ask you to take note of our dedication and commitment to the spirit of democracy, which has made our blessed country, the United States of America, so great and unique in world history. As we stand before you, we recognize and understand that the city of Southfield is a model for that which American democracy stands. Southfield is a city of multicultural diversity. Our city is comprised of individuals and families of varying cultural, religious, and ethnic backgrounds. Our diversity is our strength. It has given us the opportunity to learn and respect the differences of our neighbors and to work together for the common good of our community. We offer our prayers that you allow us to continue to respect one another and live together in harmony and peace. In these challenging times when terror and threats to freedom and democracy shake our world, we beseech you to have compassion and mercy upon those who live in fear and face unimaginable devastation and tyranny. Send your healing powers to all those who are wounded physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Enlighten the hearts and minds of those who carry out these atrocities to see the evil of their deeds, so that they may change course and embrace a more peaceful and enlightened path. Allow all of us the strength and resolve to navigate through these difficult times and grant us all salvation and protection so that we will be able to see and experience a better and brighter future. Lastly, we pray this evening that you, the Supreme King of Kings, guard and protect the constituted officers of our Southfield government. Grant them insight and understanding to carry out their responsibilities with wisdom, honesty, and integrity. Allow them to humbly debate the great issues of the day in a spirit of mutual respect and harmony. Let them set aside personal interests and rather mayor and council and all city officials work together for the common good of our city. Grant them success in their endeavors. Bless them with continued strength, vitality, and health for themselves, their families, and the outstanding residents and employees of our beloved city. May this be your will, and let us respond. Amen.
Please be seated. Thank you, Rabbi Morris, for your thoughtful words. We're delighted to have you here with us tonight to help us wish our elected officials many effective years of work on your behalf. First of all, we'd like to acknowledge several of the dignitaries who are also here with us this evening. Joining us are federal, state, and county officials or their representatives. I would ask that you please hold your applause until I have introduced all of them. Please stand and remain standing as I call your names. We have a representative from United States Senator Gary Peters' office with us this evening. United States Congresswoman Brenda Lawrence is here. State Senator Vincent Gregory is also with us this evening. Former City Council members Roy T. Bell, Susan Goldstein, Sylvia Jordan, also with us this evening, Bill Latimer, and Barbara Talley. From the 46th District Court, we have Judge Cynthia Arvent, Chief Judge Sheila Johnson, Judge Deborah Nance, and retired Judge Susan Moiseef. Also joining us this evening from the Southfield Public School Board is Dr. Linda C. Wood. She is the superintendent of Southfield Public Schools. Please give them a round of applause. Again, thank you for being with us here this evening. It's now my pleasure to introduce City Clerk Nancy L. M. Banks, who will administer the oath of office to Mayor Kenson Cipher.
You raise your right hand. Do you hereby swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution of the United States, the Constitution of this state, and the Southfield City Charter, and that you will faithfully perform the duties as mayor in and for the city of Southfield, County of Oakland, State of Michigan, according to the best of your ability?
I do, to the great city of Southfield.
We will continue, and I also want to acknowledge and thank you for this note, sir. Judge Leona Lloyd of the 36th District Court is also in attendance this evening. Judge Lloyd, thank you.
Also, we have a school board member.
Oh, and we also have a school board member who is also with us here this evening. We want to make sure that we acknowledge everyone correctly, and we don't miss any names. Radio announcers are great for missing names, and we don't want to do that by any stretch of the imagination. Betty Robinson is here also. Thank you very much, Betty. Thank you. I hope I have not missed anyone else. So, and I'm sorry, Ms. Jackson. She is.
Lenny Taylor.
Oh, Lenny Taylor is here with us. Thank you.
Janet Jackson.
And Janet Jackson is also here. Janet? Thank you. Thank you very much. And now we continue on. Clerk Banks will administer the oath of office to Councilman Daniel Brightwell.
Yay! Raise your right hand, please. Do you hereby swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution of the United States, the Constitution of this state, and the Southfield City Charter, and that you will faithfully perform the duties as councilman in and for the City of Southfield, County of Oakland, State of Michigan, according to the best of your ability.
I will.
Congratulations. Thank you.
And now Clerk Banks will administer the oath of office to Councilman Lloyd C. Cruz.
Raise your right hand, please. Do you hereby swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution of the United States, the Constitution of this state, and the Southfield City Charter, and that you will faithfully perform the duties as councilman in and for the City of Southfield, County of Oakland, State of Michigan, according to the best of your ability?
Yes, I will.
Congratulations. Yay!
Our ceremony continues with City Clerk Banks administering the oath of office to Councilman Donald F. Fracassi.
You what? Okay. Would you raise your right hand, please? Do you hereby swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution of the United States, the Constitution of this state, and the Southfield City Charter, and that you will faithfully perform the duties as councilman in and for the City of Southfield, County of Oakland, State of Michigan, according to the best of your ability?
I do.
Thank you. Sure. Okay, thank you.
And now, City Clerk Nancy Ellen Banks will administer the oath to Councilwoman Tanya Morris.
Raise your right hand, please. Do you hereby swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution of the United States, the Constitution of this state, and the Southfield City Charter, and that you will faithfully perform the duties as councilwoman in and for the City of Southfield, County of Oakland, State of Michigan, according to the best of your ability?
Yes, I do.
Thank you.
Although they are not part of tonight's swearing-in ceremonies, they are with us here tonight, elected officials, Councilman Myron Frazier, Councilwoman Joan Seymour, and Councilman Michael A. Mandelbaum. Next on the program is a brief City Council meeting, and we ask Mr. Mayor, members of City Council, Mr. Treasurer, and Madam Clerk to please take your seats for this meeting.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is a regular meeting of the Council of the City of Southfield for Monday, November 16th, 2015. Madam Clerk, would you please call the roll?
Thank you. Mr. Cruz?
Present.
Mr. Brightwell?
Present.
Mr. Fracassi?
Here.
Mr. Frazier?
Here.
Ms. Morris?
Here.
Mr. Mandelbaum?
Here.
Ms. Seymour?
Present.
You have 7 members present.
Thank you. We have no presentations this evening. We are now going to move to the oath of office, swearing in of the newly elected officials. We have done that. And next we have, well, I'm reading the agenda. The next thing is the council election of officers. And Madam Clerk?
Okay, thank you. You will need to have someone make a motion for council
motion
president
for,
and then a motion.
We need a motion for the office of president. Yes.
I'd like to nominate Councilman Myron Frazier for office of the council president.
Do we have a second support? Seconded by Mr. Brightwell. Do we need to do a roll call, Madam Clerk? We need to do a roll call.
You may want to ask if there's any other nominations.
Any other nominations? Hearing none?
No, I think you can just do it.
I think it's that's it by acclamation, correct?
Correct.
Next, we need a nomination for the Council President Pro Tem.
Madam President?
Can you speak up, sir?
I'd like to nominate Councilman Lloyd Cruz for Council President Pro Tem.
And do we have a support?
Support.
We have a nomination and a support. Any other nominations? All in favor? By acclamation? Yes, by acclamation,
correct,
we have the two officers. Now we have, is there anything else, Madam Clerk, that we have to conduct at this point in time?
Thank you. I believe that the new mayor would like to say a few words, and then following the mayor, the council president.
Yes, Mr. Mayor Seiver.
Correct.
You would like to, it's your turn.
I believe that Congresswoman Brenda Lawrence has something to say first.
This is a very powerful night for me here today in this great city of Southfield, a place that I have served and continue to serve for over 20 years. Democracy again has spoken, and we are choosing new leaders for our city. I remember when I came on the council and it was 4 new members, and it was an exciting time in the city. I'm standing here today excited about the future of this city. I'm excited about the opportunity that we have after election, that we have spoken as a people, and now it's time to move on. It's time for us to recognize the commitment that so many people have given to this city, thank them, and now support those who we put in place to serve this great city and to represent our voices. I would like to introduce the next mayor, the new mayor. He's not next, he's now the mayor. I would like to introduce the mayor of this great city, Dr. Kenson Seiver. Ladies and gentlemen, a mayor is a person who is, a lot of times people put a lot of names on it. They'll say it's the face of the community. It's the person who stands up when someone needs to speak out or someone needs to stand up for the city and for the people. Some people call him a ribbon cutter, But you know what's so significant about that? Every time we have economic development, you will see your mayor standing there proudly cutting the ribbon. Some people say that the mayor is the one that the rubber hits the road because they get blamed for everything. And you know what? When he took that oath, he took that with pride. I've had the opportunity to work with him. We've talked continuously during the time that I've served this city. And even when I was on school board, we worked together. And so I'm so excited to pass the mantle through Donald Fakasi to Ken Sensiver to be my mayor. Ladies and gentlemen, the mayor of the city of Southfield, Dr. Ken Sensiver.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
It's a pleasure to be here this evening. And I want to thank my congresswoman, congressmayor, as we call her, our state representatives, our county commissioners, my city council members, past and present, our city clerk Banks, Treasurer Loewenberg, judges of the 46th District Court, and all of you honored ladies and gentlemen. And let me just start by saying I am so glad to be before you this evening with and not have someone sitting in the front row with a stopwatch counting off 60 seconds well, I'm trying to think of something pithy to say in a one-minute answer. You know, honestly, I'm an explainer. Once a teacher, always a teacher. And bear with me, I need more time. So, and first, first I'd like you to ponder this evening for a moment that really many of us are here tonight because of United States Senator Carl Levin. Southfield became the epicenter of the wakes of created by Senator Levin's retirement announcement nearly 2 years ago. And the political dominoes began to fall. So first we had Congressman Gary Peters announce his candidacy for Levin's seat. Then we had State Rep Rudy Hobbs and Southfield Mayor Brenda Lawrence announce their candidacy and run for Gary Peters' seat in Congress. Councilman Jeremy Moss then ran for Rudy Hobbs' seat in the state legislature and succeeded. Lloyd Cruz was appointed to fill Jeremy's seat on city council. Donald Fakasi took on the role of acting mayor when our Congress mayor left for Congress last January. And by the requirements set forth in the city council, I resigned from city council last spring to officially run for mayor. And Ari Mandelbaum was appointed to fill my seat on city council. To say the least, this has been interesting to see all of this play out. And I think this is the end of the political dominoes, at least for now. So the Southfield mayor's race that just concluded really began in August of 2014 when Brenda Lawrence won the primary in the 14th Congressional District. And it has been a very long 15 months. 15 months that included attempts by an anonymous few to divide this community. I stand here tonight as a testament to the good people of Southfield who saw through the dirty tricks, who saw through the race baiting, the homophobia, and the distortions of truth. This is the Southfield I know. The Southfield that's in this room. This is a city where we get along. This is a city where we appreciate our diversity, where we are a model for inclusion, and we're going to keep it that way. I want to thank the voters who looked at my long track record of public service and my vision for our city and voted for me to become the sixth mayor of Southfield. I am extremely humbled by the faith that has been placed in me to lead this great city, and I vow to continue to work very hard on behalf of all citizens of our city. I want you to know that I feel very optimistic about the future of Southfield. We have weathered some very tough times that were caused by external forces beyond our control, the mortgage crisis, and the near collapse of the U.S. economy. Our late city manager, Jim Charette, then Mayor Lawrence, and the city council navigated very, very stormy seas and brought us safely to shore with only relatively minor inconveniences to our residents and to our business community. I also must credit city staff for recognizing the financial challenges we faced, including a significant loss of our tax revenue and making sacrifices so that the council, or rather that the city, could stay afloat. They have done more with less. I believe it is now time to recognize those sacrifices and settle our employee contracts within the parameters of what we can afford. My optimism for Southfield Southfield's future is based on our excellent police and fire departments and the fact that for the eighth consecutive year, we have experienced a decline in major crimes in this city, and that's worth applauding. And I'll just say that walking over 10,000 doors this summer, one of the things I heard over and over again is an appreciation for our police, fire, and EMS. They're tremendous. My optimism is also furthered by the fact that we have rising property values. This year, we had an increase in tax revenues, although costs have risen as well. Declining vacancy rates in our large office towers and centers. New companies are moving into the city. We have Elring, Klinger Automotive, Dura Automotive. By the way, the remake of the old DT building on Northwestern Highway is phenomenal. Hello World, the return of Covisint to Southfield from downtown Detroit. New developments on Southfield Road north of 12 Mile and with more to come. Growth of the Tech Quarter on Lower Telegraph, a new Toyota dealership on Telegraph, the rehabilitation of the Holiday Inn and the Comerica building on Telegraph Road, the opening of the new plastic and coatings lab at BASF and the new jobs that come with it, a new dorm and STEM building at Lawrence Technological University, and increased enrollment at the university. The expansion of Automation Alley and the Smart Zone and the new business incubator at LTU. And we have even new retail replacing several dilapidated buildings on 8 Mile Road. And of course, we have the near completion of the Evergreen Road project. And isn't it beautiful? I also want to, I'm optimistic because last March we appointed a new public arts commission, and you know that's been an emphasis or project of mine, and they've been off to a great start. My optimism is furthered as we convene this new city council. But first I want to recognize and thank Sidney Lance for 32 years of service to the city of Southfield as a city councilman. I also thank and recognize Sylvia Jordan for 16 years of service as a councilwoman. I extend my thanks and appreciation to Donald Percasi, who served as our acting mayor this last year, and I congratulate Don on his re-election to City Council. My congratulations also go to Tanya Morris, Dan Brightwell, and Lloyd Cruz on their election to Council. And I truly look forward to the fresh perspectives these council persons will bring to our governance and our discourse. And I look forward to continuing to work with Council President Myron Fraser, Council persons Ari Mandelbaum, and Joan Seymour. And of course, City Clerk Banks, Treasurer Loewenberg, City Administrator Zorn, Deputy Administrator John Mascherina, City Attorney Sue Ward, Terry Crode, our City Planner, Business Development Director Shelley Freeman, and many other city staff, too numerous to mention. And I see a new era of collaboration and cooperation at City Hall. So what can the citizens and staff expect from the Cyber administration? The mayor's office will have an open door policy. There'll be transparency in government and greater communication with our various constituencies. Paramount to me is prompt response and follow through with all constituents. I may not always be able to tell you what you want to hear, but you will get an answer. As this new council and mayor begin work, I am calling for a visioning session of the elected officials to be held in December. We need to come together to build a consensus on city priorities for the next 2 years. The budget process for 2016-17 begins in January. It's imperative that priorities are set before our staff goes to work on creating next year's preliminary budget. Those of us who have come off this election cycle know what is on the mind of Southfield voters. Hands down, the top concern of residents is repairing our local roads. We heard it over and over and over again. Please fix the roads. Well, the good news is that we have a road plan in place. And this year, this past year, and I'll use the word loosely, we have enjoyed more road construction in Southfield than in any other community in Oakland County. Besides Evergreen Road, we've had road, water, and sewer projects in Cranbrook, Washington Heights, Cambridge Village, Meadowvale, and Tapper's Baseline neighborhoods. And on big stretches of Northwestern Highway Service Drive, Providence Drive, First Center Drive, Bridge Street, Light Industrial Park, 10 Mile and Greenfield, the intersection, and 11 Mile and Franklin Road. We can look forward to enjoying equally busy road construction seasons in the years ahead. Further, we expect with the passage of the state's new road funding bill that we will see more funds pour into Southfield to augment our $99 million bond road fund. The second most frequent concern on the mind of voters this year is code enforcement and neighborhood appearances. As mayor, I will be bringing to council an 8-point plan to strengthen our neighborhoods and create reinvestment opportunities for our aging housing stock. Let's face it, this city has wonderful neighborhoods with a broad spectrum of housing options. We have modest to sprawling ranch homes, colonials, bungalows, Cape Cods, McMansions, townhomes, a great assortment of condos and high-rise living. However, most of our housing stock is now 40, 50, 60, 70 years old. We must reinvest. We must update, and we must prevent blight. I am proposing that we create a pilot neighborhood enterprise zone. We take advantage of a state law that allows communities to set aside a relatively small percentage of housing for renewal through tax abatements for homeowners in exchange for major home improvements. Under this program, I propose we identify, and again, on a trial basis to see if it works, a neighborhood with homes built before 1960 to encourage renewal and reinvestment by homeowners. Secondly, I propose the creation of a Southfield Neighborhood Stabilization Program, similar to the federally funded neighborhood stimulus program that President Obama created several years back. The Southfield program would take tax foreclosed properties from the Oakland County Treasurer to rehabilitate and sell at a modest profit to families. I sat through the annual county foreclosed real estate auction and have witnessed firsthand flippers, house flippers, and real estate interests grab up homes and condos in Southfield. The result has been that we now have many more rental properties in our community than ever before. Now, I do not mean to denigrate these parties or those who rent homes. However, most certainly there are many reputable landlords in our city. I'm one. But I also know that we have, and I've seen this firsthand, that there are landlords who are not doing right by our neighbors and our neighborhoods, leading to the destabilization of our neighborhoods. We have to address this. Thirdly, along the same lines, I want to see the reinvigoration of our rental home registration program and and the enforcement of our rental home inspection program. We must pursue those landlords who are not maintaining their properties. Inspection of rental homes should be required before a new tenant moves in. The cost of the rental home inspection program would be borne by the landlord, as would necessary repairs and improvements to the house itself, as well as the landscaping. With rental registration, inspections, and rising property values, a result just might be the sale of rental properties to more permanent residents. Fourthly, we are an aging community. We have many long-time residents who are aging in place, continuing to live in their family home. I think it's great, and I'm planning to do the same. However, we must recognize that some of our most elderly homeowners are having difficulty with home repairs and landscaping. I would like to see the expansion of the CHORE program and other forms of assistance so that we may help our most aged residents, allow them to stay in their homes while we are promoting curb appeal. Fifthly, code enforcement. During the campaign, I spoke extensively on this and received considerable support from our voters. I believe we need to hire more code officers and shrink the amount of territory that each is currently responsible for. I would like to hold a code enforcement summit with our community in the pavilion for the purpose of reviewing our appearance codes and procedures and also getting feedback from residents. If this is, if the result is, as many have asked for, stricter code enforcement standards, then we as a community are going to have to step up and support our elected officials and our code officers as we undertake this initiative. Years ago, I coined the term the Southfield Standard. We do things right in this city, and I believe in standards. Maintaining them is not always the most popular thing to do. However, we must not allow our community standards to slip, and we all want to live in an attractive, safe, and clean community. Sixth, we need to have a housing study performed to better gauge our future housing needs. Additionally, the study would help us attract housing developers and investors. The Southfield Nonprofit Housing Board, of which I am the chair, has already agreed to pay for half of the cost of such a study. I have asked the city administration to help finance the rest. Seventh, I think we should investigate historic designations for some of our older housing. By the way, a house only has, or a building only has to be 50 years old to get a historic designation. Grant funds are available from state agencies to inventory historic properties, and historic designations can equate to tax credits and preservation funding. And finally, I propose the expansion of our Community Pride Award program. Each year we salute the tremendous efforts of homeowners who've created showplace yards. And I greatly appreciate and applaud their efforts because they create these magnificent landscapes, and I certainly want them to continue to do so. But I also would like to see us recognize and encourage those who keep well-tended, neat yards, but who may not have that green thumb or the means or times to invest in great displays of flowers, fountains, yard ornamentation, and the like. The point being that we want to recognize and encourage as much curb appeal as possible. I want it to be contagious. Additionally, I propose that we recognize our outstanding business properties, large and small, as part of the Community Pride Award program. And conversely, we need to enforce our perpetual maintenance agreements that the city holds with numerous property owners. Certainly, curb appeal applies to businesses as well as homeowners, and we have some businesses that are not, in my view, meeting the Southfield standard. There are a host of other issues that the council and mayor will tackle in the course of the next 2 years, including the demolition and redevelopment of Northland, the further development of the city center, and let me add, we are indeed fortunate to have Lawrence Tech as a partner in this endeavor. We will need to step up our marketing of this city and the Smart Zone. We need to develop a system of tracking contracts with minority-owned businesses and contractors and expand the outreach to the same. We need to be able to measure what we are doing, and this is an area that I would like to see us measure. We need also to develop a plan to defend the city against fracking, oil and gas drilling, and or mineral exploration in the city. We do not want to live with oil wells in our neighborhoods or fracking in Southfield. We still have people in this city who get their drinking water from the ground, and we need to protect that. Other issues that we'll be tackling: attraction and retention of businesses. I plan to work very closely with the DDA, the various chambers of commerce that we have in Southfield, our City Center Advisory Board, our business development team, Lawrence Tech, Providence Hospital, OCC, and others. We need to work on the expansion of our green technologies and practices. After all, this is our future and for the generations to come. We need to separate the sanitary and storm sewers on the east side of this city so that we can eliminate basement flooding and the reduction of septic tank use on the west side. We need to work on the attraction and retention of our millennials. I want Southfield to be a cool city. And we need to continue the revitalization of public art in our city. Our newly formed Public Art Commission has made great strides in the short time that it has been in existence. I will ask the City Council to have further discussion on the stalled 1% ordinance. Every major city in the United States requires developers to create set-asides in their construction budgets or renovation budgets for art, be it landscaping, architectural features to buildings, sculpture, murals, any other artistic components. And we're only asking at a max up to $25,000 of the total project value to be set aside for art. This ordinance will help us create a more vibrant streetscape and a greater sense of place. I want to close by saying that this is an exciting time to be in Southfield, and I am extremely excited to serve as your mayor. Together, the City Council, administration, and I will work hard, we promise you that, to move this city forward. And again, I thank the voters who have placed their trust in me. I will not let you down. And I thank all of you for being here this evening, and good night.
Next, please be seated. Please be seated. Next, we will hear from our newly elected Council President Myron Fraser. But first, in keeping with tradition, I am going to pass the gavel to him and let him take the seat.
Thank you so much. First of all, I realize that I'm standing between you and a punch and cookies, so I'm not gonna take a long time. And I have no prepared speech. I didn't have time after I wrote Ken's. But to begin with, I would like to thank my wife of 55 years, who's sitting right over there, and my family who has supported me throughout my years of volunteer work, and I consider this volunteer work giving back to the community. It took me a long time to realize that my wife was calling around to different volunteer organizations, asking them if they needed some help because she had a volunteer, so I'd get out of the house. So, but I would also like to thank the rest of my council for putting their trust in me and electing me president for this year. I promise you that we're going to be a team, that we're going to work together as a team to get the things done that need to get done, some of the things that our new mayor has outlined, and other things that I've got up my sleeve that I won't be able to talk about tonight, but we will talk about and move forward. But I also want to thank all of those people that put their hat in the ring to be elected to city council, but were not successful. I'm saying do not give up. We need you. We need you on boards, commissions, working to help make Southfield a stronger, better, cooler city. And so don't go away. We need you. I would like to make my comments very brief because I would like to give my colleagues that were elected this evening, and or not elected, but sworn in this evening, an opportunity to say a few words and let you hear from them and not at the League of Women Voters thing where they're limited to a minute. And I'll start with Mr. Brightwell.
Well, I am extremely pleased to be here. I promise to do a very good job for the city of Southfield. I promise to make this a full-time job. I'm basically retired, so Southfield becomes my work on a going-forward basis. And I want to thank all my supporters. One of the most enjoyable things in the world is to have people to support you unconditionally. I have a lot of my veteran friends My sister flew in from Atlanta. She worked a poll for me for several hours, and that's the talk of the town in the community in Atlanta. But I'm extremely pleased, and I'm just glad that I won. I'm glad for my team that we put together, those guys and men and women. A couple of them brought their kids out with them, so I'm just thoroughly pleased. And I think I might be running over, but I'm pleased, and I'm going to work very hard to do good things for the city of Southfield.
Mr. Cruz.
Good evening, residents of the city of Southfield. Thank you all for being here this evening. It's a very humbling occasion for me to now not only have been appointed, but now elected. Makes a huge difference. But again, as you all know, and as I think as we all agree here up here today, is that it was never about us personally. Even though this race, when you go through the campaigning, it can be very grueling, it's very tough, be very isolating sometimes, and you feel like you're out here all by yourself. But I see a lot of faces out here that I know have my back, okay? And that you all trust me, I will do everything I can to serve this city to the best of my ability. Lastly, so I won't hold it up any longer, but I do just want to allow my son to stand up, if you wouldn't mind, Jameer. Just give him a little wave. Because then that is really what it's all about. That's my number one guy right there. Everything I do, I'm doing with him in mind and trying to be the best example and role model for him that I can be every day. And I think public service is a huge way to show and be an example for young people today. So with that all said, thank you all for your time this evening. And I look forward to talking to you outside.
Mr. Fricassi.
Yeah. To everyone here, my family, is this on? I think so. Can you hear me out there? Kind of. All right. I just want to thank my family that's here. My wife sitting over here to my left. We have a lot of challenges ahead of us as a council, as a city, and I'm looking forward to addressing them. Thank you very much.
And Tanya Morris.
Good evening, citizens of Southfield. I just thank you for your confidence in me. I'm so excited about the opportunity to serve the city. I'd like to say thank you to all of my team as well, all the people that volunteered to help me achieve this victory. I'd like to ask my husband and my children to stand. They have been so supportive. Even in 90%.
So, residents of the city of Southfield, this is your leadership team for the city of Southfield, and we will lead the city in the positive direction. And I want to take a statement from our past city administrator, Jim Charette. And he said that Southfield is going to be the engine of growth for the city, for the Oakland County. The city of Southfield is important in Oakland County. Oakland County is important for the state of Michigan. The state of Michigan is important for the United States. So it all hangs on our shoulders. So we have to do a lot of the things that our new mayor has outlined and a lot more things that are coming up. It's going to be a tough year, and I want to thank the families of all of the council people for loaning your people to us for the amount of time that it's going to take to make this a greater city than it already is, and it is a great city. With that, if there's no more new business, the meeting is adjourned. Enjoy yourself. I'm sorry.
Yes, sir.
I'll turn it back over to you.
To finish our program tonight, Pastor James Mormon of Christian Tabernacle Church will offer the benediction.
Can we all stand for just a moment, please, as we close with the benediction, as I would do on Sunday morning, take someone by the hand. Let us agree in faith. Oh God, we pray your blessings be upon this great city of Southfield. We pray that you bless our mayor, Dr. Ken Siver. Bless this council. Bless this leadership. Let Southfield prosper beyond measure. Let Southfield become and be a beacon light, a shining example of those who love you. And we shall grow. We shall grow together. We give you praise, O God, in Jesus' name. Amen.